My name is Donna Maxey, and I was born in Albina. I was born at Emmanuel Hospital in 1949. My childhood was very idyllic, and part of that has to do with living in Albina. When we had to move, we lost our home, we lost our church. My dad lost his business, he was a barber, and we lost our community. It got wiped out from the Rose Garden all the way up to Fremont, just about. My father's barbershop was just one of many black-owned businesses that were right there in that hub. I don't remember exactly the last day, but I remember we all walked through the house and made sure it was empty and kind of said goodbye to the house and cried. It was hard. It was very hard. I had very fond memories of that house and of the life that we had there.
Hearing Donna's voice is grounding. They are reminders that although the Albina Vision Trust has been conjuring up a do-over for this part of town for more than 4 years, Black folk been thinking about it for more than 75. The Albina Vision Trust team got together more than 4 years ago to begin to vision a new way of thinking about this Central City neighborhood, 94 acres in the Central City, adjacent to the river, within walking distance of downtown. We could either sit and watch it change or influence it changing over time. How are we going to regard each other in more equitable ways? How can we take better care of each other in urban design? We had to be intentionally remarkable in how we destroyed that community, and we believe we have to be intentionally remarkable in how we rebuild it, how we imagine to care for each other, how this part of the city stitches our communities back and reconnects us to the river. Some of this is big thinking because we want to be big and exceptional in how we live together in the city.